Alice?
I don't need it, but.
Okay. All right, Jake, are you all good to go? Right on. So we're opening a meeting on Thursday, October 26th at 7:03, 2023. We got Angus, Amelia, Sabrina, Alice, and we've got Jake. And let's look at the minutes from September 28th. Throw down an E on the end of there.
I'm trying to find it on here, so.
It's just above the select board ex officio report.
So home, so right there. She just needs to be. So it's U E?
H O G U A. Yeah. What do you think?
Looks good to me. Motion to accept the minutes.
Second motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Great. I haven't received any notable correspondence, and so our primary thing to do tonight is to look over the subdivision application for Anson and Jen Smith. And Anson and Aaron Simpson, his lawyer, are at the Canaan Planning Board meeting as we speak for a very brief period and are planning to be here around 7:30. Let's look at this and see how long it takes us to look at it, and I can check in with Anson and his cell number. I'm not convinced they need to be here for this, but our goal tonight is to tell them what we need from them, accept the application as complete, and figure out if we can do a public hearing on November 16th. And that gives us 3 weeks, and that should be plenty for what we need. We just need to look into this packet and see if we have everything we need, and if we don't, we can ask for it. And I'm sure that as long as we get it the next few business days, it'll all work out. I've been in touch with them for days. Anson dropped it off to me today, but I've seen it for, you know, the last week and a half, working through with Anson and Carissa and Aaron about what to expect. So, so we have two sets of plans that we can look at in a little bit. Jason Seale. Alice, do you want to come around?
Yes, actually, I do. Actually, I'm going to stand up.
Let's get right in. So this is the wetlands classification map. This over there is provided because they require a state permit for that. So it looks like the same thing. Now this is the same thing, but with the lots incorporated into it. So we can see that they have like hypothetical septic and well, and how that fits in with certain things. Right, because we have we'll look at the driveways that is, this is just for the wetlands, I guess. So this is state-specific requirements about how to make sure that stuff doesn't get damaged and runoff doesn't get exacerbated. There's a nice Water Division state stamp from DES. Correct. So that's something that we need to be. It's outside. It's on a list of things to check off. Okay. There are two sets. This is the second set. I'm going to let them deal with the fact that they put the wrong county in there. Cut and paste, just like Orange Master Plan. And, this is just like, yeah, that's all that is. Kind of seems like that's what's happening, and there's one for, I just don't know why there's this triple. Or is that just,
maybe it just got caught up.
I think it just got captured, huh? Several saved is typical. Because, I don't know, like I went and had to reference a subdivision from the 80s, and it was really helpful to have four copies up in the file, because I could take one and not feel like it was the last one. So, Anthony has given us a $50 check, which is a necessary request, but we had already printed it out, and it'll certainly cost at least that over the course of the whole thing. So,
they're gonna
place the ad themselves.
Okay. So we don't have to worry about that.
Correct. All we have to worry about is the fact that they end up actually doing it.
Yes.
And as long as we stay on them.
And is there a time limit?
There is. It needs to be 10 clear days before the public hearing. And clear days means that the day of the hearing and the day that the ad is posted do not...
That's 10 business days.
10 clear business days. And the day of the hearing and the day of the ad posting cannot be those days. So if you're including both those days, that's what it has to be outside those days. So that means that it would need to be, I think it would be need to be sent by like November 1st.
That makes sense.
Yeah. And so that's basically I told him is that like, sure, you can scramble and do it tomorrow. But as long as it happens early next week, it's fine.
Don't give me too much time.
But you're also gonna want to tell Valley News right away, because often it takes a couple days for that to happen. We have the Smith subdivision. The description of where it is on the 4A. Tax map and lot number, Anthony and Jen Smith, where they live and their phones. We have their lawyer, Aaron Simpson, appointed to represent, and where his office is. This is the update of the abutters list. Notably, it's the Enfield line, so that there are three abutters in Enfield as well. The date of the regular planning board meeting at which application for approval of final subdivision plat is to be submitted to the board. I don't know if this is filled in the right way, but... Right, technically tonight is the night that it is being, the application is being, right. That's fine though. Have the requirements for final plat submission been met in their entirety? Because according to them, they have yet to receive state DOT approval for the driveways. And there's a clearly written state law that says we are not allowed to delay processing the application. And so we can approve the application as, we can accept it as complete, we can move to hold a public hearing. We're not legally allowed to postpone it.
Yeah, okay.
But if when November 16th comes around at the public hearing, if the state driveway permits have not come through, we are allowed to approve the subdivision, but we're not allowed to sign it and send it. And we have to sign it at a future planning board meeting once that approval has been received. And so the detail here is that another public hearing does not need to be held. that's the catch with all this, is that like you don't, like as long as you can approve the thing conditional to this, that, or the other, you only need to hold one public hearing. And so 7 lots, major subdivision. Right, and they've filled out these extra things, which are and so this is the point at which we will need to fill this stuff out. I forgot a pen.
Anything else?
What part of it? Okay. Okay. So for practical purposes, the application is received tonight, and it was effectively received a week ago. So if anyone wants to make a complaint about when it was actually turned in, whatever. But this, I think the board has a first had a chance to see it tonight. Actually, maybe that's more like it. I should put 20 that the application was received and because we are accepting this tonight, whether we have to stay here until midnight to sign it in. Okay, so what this means, what the 90-day review period means, is that if we fail to take action in 90 days, it is automatically approved, and we're not allowed to. I think I think that from that. I don't know exactly what 90 days would be, but it's not going to be 90 days. We'll call it the 26th of January. What's the right term for when like you wait out the clock? Is there like a legal term for that? Besides, like a sports reference,
statute of limitations.
Well, there's that, but that might be the opposite, right?
That's something else.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or maybe that. I
just got running out of the clock
in my head. Right. The set. Okay. So date of butter notification to be mailed by. We figured it would be November 1st. Is when that needs to be mailed.
And that does give you fewer days, you said?
That is, well, that's the last day that it could be mailed.
Okay.
So it would be advisable for them to do it tomorrow or Monday or Tuesday.
So we don't know if they've done that yet.
I know they haven't because I told them not to, because they were really wanting to, and I told them it would be wise to not do that until we get this step done.
You're talking about the abutters,
I think,
right?
That a holiday doesn't count.
Oh, Veterans Day.
So I think really the 31st is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay,
count the date.
9,
10.
I buy that. Yeah. Okay, let's do that. All right, Anson Smith texted me. We are leaving the Canaan meeting now and heading to Grafton. Thank you. So the date of the public hearing will be 16th of November. And the date the public hearing notices to be mailed and published by are also the 31st. But that's when it needs to be in the paper.
Why did they choose this? I'm just wondering why they chose the 16th.
We did.
We did, because we can't do it any sooner because it wouldn't have given enough clear days.
Okay, so I wasn't sure if it was a specific thing.
No, no, we simply chose it because we can't do the regular thing because of Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
I mean, conceivably we could choose a different day of the week, but...
So that is our November meeting.
Correct.
Oh, I thought your email says...
We switched it. We had to switch it because of this.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Yeah.
Sorry.
The meeting minutes are wrong then, because it says...
They were correct, but they're not anymore. So maybe it's worth...
Okay.
Okay, so we were planning on having a meeting on the 19th.
We had to.
Okay, so that makes more sense. That's why I was wondering. I was like, we're having a meeting the week before.
Yeah. No, sorry. This is... Okay. So date of site evaluation, we have to decide if we need to do a site evaluation. I've been there before, I know what they're doing. Yeah, you already kind of checked it out. Well, we certainly could have a field trip. Does anyone have the subdivision regs with them? That's already done. In fact, that's the only person I think I actually successfully notified.
Okay, so you have
that.
To call me.
Right. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. To be perfectly honest, the site evaluation does not require a visit. It's all just making sure that we have these things about perk tests and stuff. So I just assume be okay with that. Thank you. And then fees paid so far, we've received $50. It's the 6th.
And that's to cover the letters?
The only thing that they're going to have to pay for is, or the only thing that they're going to have to pay us for is the Mylar mailing and the county registry and LCHIP fees, which are probably going to total $60 or so.
So they're going to get us a copy of the certified mail slips, and then they're
taking care of it. Right. Yeah, right. So we don't have to be reimbursed for either the butters or the newspaper notice. Just You guys familiar with the homestead property? This is not homestead property clause. Mm-hmm. This is something I learned about recently. Like, I've seen it many times, but like, a lot of properties say this is not homestead property. And like, you know, from the intuitive interpretation is, you're not allowed to live there.
Yeah.
That's not what it means. It means that when you do have homestead property, there's some rights where if you run out of money, you can't be kicked out of where you live. And by putting this in here, it makes it so that like not all parties related to the deed need to be tracked down in case that happened. And in case like people are divorced and like, you know, somebody can come back and be like, but this is where I was living, and like, you can't take this away from me. And I guess this is their like smart way of like nipping that in the bud.
Yeah.
But it's just such a weird like.
Yeah, the wording is.
Like, leave it to the all caps, too, right? Like, it's, what I'm looking for is a fee, which I saw, I thought. For the application, but I'm losing my mind because I was under the impression that we didn't have like a board specific fee, and that it was just covering for the L chip and everything. Let me just see if what I received is. Right, so allegedly there's a $25 application fee, which we have never done in years that I've seen, so.
Is it something we want to start doing, or just waive it from?
I was expecting to waive it and just charge like the actual amount that is. Because it's not like we're getting reimbursed for driving here from that.
No,
whether
it just goes back.
It just goes back into the general fund, yeah, so. My guess is that the $25 fee is like, supposed to cover the Mylar mailing and the tube and everything, but.
But it's. Yeah, I guess so.
Well, that's the Mylar to the county.
Okay.
And then, but it's actually $26 now, mm-hmm. And then it's $25 for L-Chip.
Yeah.
So it, whatever, we can ask them for $10 more. We should probably ask for it in like nickels or something. Right, so they'll probably be here any minute, and I think that.
What's the attorney's name?
Aaron Simpson. This is part of why I'm hoping to redo this entirely, because I don't feel like this application is intuitive and it includes things that in the last 10 years I've never seen.
No. We're talking about having one for subdivision and one for major.
One for major, one for minor, one for lot line adjustment, one for long-term record.
Makes sense to me. And I think if I ever had to do this, I'd be like, why is this not together? And what do I need to fill out?
Oh, totally. It's...
yeah.
So I can just itemize what you're going to need. Twenty-six for the Mylar record. That is supposing that it is just one Mylar that's being recorded. I think it probably is. We're going to need 25 for L-chip. And then we've typically done just $10 for the annealing, which is that, yeah. I shut them.
Oh, okay. Just like a little crazy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Textbook gaslighting.
Yes. This will keep recording my.
I don't know.
I don't think so. But
you can stop it, change your calendar, and then start recording.
Yes, we're not doing anything.
Just remember to start it again. You'll have two
videos.
It'll be two
videos.
Yeah.
Did I contact you and tell you I went to the budget meeting?
Did I?
Yeah.
Which, the one like this Tuesday?
No.
Like
when we had to get approval for.
Right. And they didn't treat, it wasn't the Spanish Inquisition.
No, it was like, we're going to give you $200, it's a fine thing.
Thanks a lot, we won't use it.
Well, that's what they said. Well, what do you use it for? I said, well, we use it for mailing and stuff, and they get reimbursed, and then it just goes back. And so,
yeah,
they did something wrong with it.
Yeah.
It could be worse. I could ask for $5,000 so we could
join
the Sotheby's thing, but we're not.
Right.
Let's.
We're
not going to do that. That'll be information.
I mean, the revolving account thing, I've received some pushback about that. And it's like, okay, like, well, it's. You know, let's say that somebody doesn't manage to pay.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, we're not going to let that happen, but if it did, it's not the end of the world. It's better to be prepared for that.
Mm-hmm.
These dollar amounts are not very large.
No,
neither are we.
In today's world, yeah.
I got a question.
What's up, Jay?
Where does all these documents sit? Are they in the office? by Sarah?
What's that?
Where's all this information kept? Is it by with Sarah at the office?
Like all these things? In a series of filing cabinets upstairs.
Okay.
In the selectman's office. Yeah.
Have you returned the DOT map to the office?
We made copies.
There's copies, okay.
Oh, the DOT map. Yeah, no, I think that's back there.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Last time I inquired, which was a while back, she said you had it.
Yeah, I may still, I can't remember. I think it's back there, but I'm not entirely sure. You're talking about like the nodular one or the nodal? The one that has different points on it that was up for...
Yeah. I didn't see it. It's the one that you presented here
at
the meeting.
Yeah, I don't honestly remember whether I have it or whether it's there, but I can look. Are you still wondering about what's going on with the farm?
No, I think, well, I don't know that anything has changed there, but I just wanted to take a look at it.
Okay.
I know nothing has changed with the farm, and the boulders are still there.
Okay.
I was there a few weeks ago, maybe a little more.
Who's responsible for moving it?
Well, the way that I've understood it to be left is that the select board has notified the landowner saying, this is a class 6 road, you need to move the boulders.
So it's up to them to follow up notice?
Correct. And
we're only in charge of updating the map.
Yeah.
And I don't know at what point the select board needs to play tough guy with the landowner. Good evening.
Hi, sorry.
It's all right. We're having an all right time. Come on up and let's get right into it. One planning board meeting blurs into the next. We've been looking this over and we don't have any real problems with it. If that makes you feel any better.
You want to vote on it?
Well, we certainly intend to vote on accepting it as complete once we get a little more info tonight, and then we'll just move along with the public hearing for the 16th if that all works out. What we did do in the meantime is determine clear days and when mailers need to be sent. It'll be Halloween that you need to mail your abutters notices by.
Okay.
If you want to do it tomorrow, more power to you.
I think the plan was to do it tomorrow.
Most importantly, if there's only one thing that you need to do tomorrow is to get in touch with Valley News, because they don't put it in next day. It's often a couple days out. And for the newspaper classified. And so if that needs to be in the paper by Halloween.
That isn't 5 days before the meeting, I think, to be in the paper, at least 5 days.
It's 10.
It's 10 days.
The same as the abutters notices.
Okay.
There's a 5, there's a 10, and there's a 15, and I always get them confused, and I'm not going to pretend like I'm absolutely correct, but the 5-day thing is the number of days that you need. You have to check the town records for abutters no more than 5 days
before the meeting.
Before the application is submitted.
Right.
It's 10 days for abutters notices and other public hearing related stuff, and it's
15 days between receiving the application and holding a public hearing. And okay. So we're teetering on the edge of pushing those 15 days right now, but the fact that you basically gave me the application a week ago, I don't care, it's fine.
The 16th is the new meeting, you said.
Correct.
Not the 9th.
Correct.
Is it business days?
It's business days.
Yeah.
And
of course.
I know, it's ridiculous. The fact remains is that there is an RSA that clarifies that
674-4.
Well, part of that it clarifies that procedural glitches are not to be held accountable, like unless it's obviously preventing people from being able to participate. You need to participate.
Right. No, I reviewed the RSA today. Unless it's overridden by your own regulation.
It's not, and it's fine. So we're doing pretty good here. What can you tell us about DOT?
So Anson submitted that they needed some more plans. I submitted a subsequent application because he was out for a while and he forgot he submitted it.
Yeah.
Hadn't shared it with me at that point. And when I resubmitted it, I got them to sign it. They're like, oh yeah, we got one, but thanks for all the deeds, which we've been, they apparently need deeds back to like 1970.
Yikes.
And I gave them deeds back to 1940 or something, because a lot of farmer deeds. You know, they came from Grandpa died in the southern area. And, so that's how we got back so far. And we gave them the surveys, and they said, yeah, we got everything we need to determine whether.
So they're processing it?
Yeah, they said it's a 45-day wait period. I anticipate.
Processing.
For processing.
They just backed up.
And they're down an engineer in the state, and different engineers will do it. Mm. And they said, I anticipate actually the 45 days will have lapsed by the time the 16th comes around.
Okay, so hopefully we'll
have the paperwork for the meeting.
Well, tell you what, this is how it works. If you have the paperwork by then, and we hold a public hearing and there's no other issues, great. If you don't have it by then, we hold a public hearing, there's no other issues, we can vote to approve it, and then we just have to hold on to things until
subject to
until you receive that.
Right.
And then the minute you receive that, we can either hold a special meeting or you can, or if it's like the next week or whatever, we can just, you don't have to be there, but I do need to sign it. I'm not going to sign it until the thing is.
Right. Other situations that we've gotten conditional approvals for things subject to the permit being issued by DOT in this case.
Yeah.
That satisfies what we've asked for.
Right.
They have this plan too.
Yeah.
But I think you can sign it any time after we can get you the paperwork to the town.
Precisely. Right. Yeah. And it's unclear to me whether we need to hold a meeting to do that. I'm not convinced we do.
I'm not going to tell you you do or don't, but I don't think you do.
I don't really think I do either, but...
It's in the nature of a conditional permit. You've got the planning... EOP manual, and
yep.
I think it talks about conditional approvals.
Right on. Okay, now that's a valuable thing to look up. And, well, anyways... So the exceptions or waivers requested are basically just conditional DOT approval. Is that the only thing we're waiting on?
That's the only thing we're waiting on. There are some things in there like that you add the regulations that the town has. I mean, they mentioned setbacks. I don't believe there are setbacks in this town. So I don't know where those conditions came from. Like you said, cut and paste. Probably.
Cut and paste. That's the answer. It's not ideal.
But, so we waive the ones that, you know, construction plan for not building a road, it's going to be a joint driveway, things like that.
That's great.
And I should have submitted it. There is one DOT driveway.
Already.
They gave it to me and the name's, you know, it doesn't mean anything. Mm-hmm. And so in the application that Anson submitted is to modify it. Mm-hmm. And they have a plan so they see where it's going.
Is that one to be modified like down the road a little bit to get both lots?
It's closer to the Peck lot, I believe.
It's on the Peck end of things.
It's near the Peck end.
Yeah. about these four things? Are these identical? They look that way?
They are. Your regs say four copies of each.
Yep.
Each plan, and so I get four copies of
I think that's
each attachment.
Yeah.
And then those are blown up copies, two sets of them.
Yeah, we looked at those.
For the detail, you know, so you can see the detail on the little plans that are in that pack.
Right. Yeah. No, we were just going over, like, why so many? And then, like, I had to go look up something, and it was from the 80s, and it was really nice to have extras in the folder upstairs, so I didn't feel like I was holding on to the last one.
Right. And you'll see, like, there's a duplicate wetland permit, but
yeah.
That was attached to the Army Corps of Engineers permit. And they referenced the plan. This is the one thing they should let you know. They referenced the plan dated May 1st. The applicant, or the person who submitted this, Audra Klum,
mm-hmm.
and she's, oh, by the way, we're going to add those to the notice list.
Yeah.
Of people would mail them to.
Right,
but
right.
Audra Klum had stamped the plan, and she said, well, the town's got one already because she submitted the wetland permit here.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, do you have conservation? So the selectman's office would
yeah.
have it. And the only other one that's stamped is at, DES, and I could probably squeeze one out of them, but.
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah. It's
so okay. That, because I was like, where's the May 1st plan? And I was not privy to what she had filed, and
yes.
She has three sets of plans in there, or the three plans.
All right. We need a. I'm sorry that this application is so, like, erroneous and scattered, and we're at least like.
By the way, regs say $20 for the application. Application itself says 25.
Well, you want to know what it actually costs? It doesn't cost anything.
You guys work for free.
We do.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, we absolutely do. We're not getting reimbursed.
I think it's meant to cover administrative time or something.
Yeah. Basically, what we've just been doing is adding. We have $26 for a mile-hour recording with the county. We've got $25 for an L chip, and we've got a blanket $10 for a mailing. To send the Mylar, and then that's what we've been charging.
So
ever since
the,
yeah, so
it's
we need $11 from you.
Oh, okay.
11 more than that.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not super worried about it coming to us right now, really,
okay.
But especially since you're doing the newspaper and the
notices.
And the notices, it doesn't mean that there's any. We have no skin in this game, right? So, that's great.
That's only if it's approved to record the plan.
Correct. That's, yeah. And so, it's probably worth just holding on to this until...
Your call.
Yeah, and I'll just keep it all together.
I
so
mean,
it's
the, the regs, the RSAs do say grounds for not accepting it is failure to pay the fee.
Totally. No, I know, but you pay it and it's written right here, so.
Okay.
We'll
get you a new check for 60.
If you want to get us a one check for 61,
right.
And we'll hold on to that, and we won't do anything with it, and we'll trade checks on the 16th.
Okay.
That makes good sense to me.
So I take that check back and give you one.
Yeah, when someone comes in, I want them to say, see the thing.
Exactly.
All right.
What's
the new check going to be made out for this?
61.
It'll give you the old one back.
Yeah.
Oh, then you.
Yeah. Someday we're going to have our act together enough to like have a clear game to play here.
We're in the hinterland, you know that, right?
That's right. Okay, so I don't think there's anything else that we really need. Unless you want to share anything specific with
it's,
us.
You know, if, I'll save it for the presentation. Just that boundary line issue on the, what is that, the west?
Right, on the town line.
Yes.
With, or is it?
Andrew.
So it's, yeah, who, I thought.
Like I said, I'd like to save it for the public hearing.
I like that. Let's do that.
It is actually north.
Right. In Grafton.
Correct.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I thought.
Barely.
Right. Okay. Well, yeah, a motion to accept the application as complete.
Okay. Motion to accept the application as complete. Should it be pending the DOT paperwork?
Yeah, conditional on DOT approval. That's,
okay.
I mean, the application is still complete.
Yes,
I think
yeah,
signing,
that's true.
Signing